How you guys doing? Mr. Horton back once again, and we are going to talk about domestic denial in our relationships. Domestic denial in our relationships, right? We got a lot of denial in these relationships, and there's a lot of domestic quarrels going on that we need to look at so we can get better. All right, so here we go. We're going to talk about, you got it here posted again on the backboard. As you can see, I think I'm going to sit on down. So, here we go. It says, domestic denial in our relationships. In many of our relationships, there seems to be different forms of denial. Webster's Dictionary defines denial as a physiological defense mechanism in which confrontation with a personal problem or a reality is avoided by denying the existence of the problem or reality. 52 weeks. In denial, refusing to admit the truth of something unpleasant, right? When things seem to be unpleasant, we tend to not want to tell the truth. Go there. Sorry. I just can't tell that. That's what most people say. I can't tell that. But sometimes you need to tell that. All right. And number one says, have you ever been in two or more relationships within the last year that ended badly, and do you believe that there was something wrong with them or nothing wrong with you? Again, let me read that. Have you ever been in two or more relationships within the last year that ended badly, and do you believe that there was something wrong with them and nothing wrong with you? When you was in these relationships, her, and her, or him, and him, or whatever, right? And it didn't go right, and you guys couldn't get along, and it just ended, and it just got ugly. Police came, whatever. Was it their fault, or could it have been somewhat your fault, or all the way your fault? Think about it, right? Number two, do you believe people that are in more than one relationship at a time are dealing with low self-esteem and low self-worth? Do you believe that a person that has multiple relationships could have low self-esteem and low self-worth? Many people and some people, especially guys in my group, they, oh, no, James, oh, no, man, he's a player. She's a player. I said, really? Man, so you're saying that, they already complete. And I'm like, well, if I'm already complete, and I'm complete even if I'm just by myself, and if I'm complete even if I'm with somebody, partially somebody or whatever, I'm complete, why do I need so many more somebodies to be complete if I'm already complete? And what am I doing this for? What am I feeding? It must be feeding something that's in me. So I just thought we should think about low self-esteem and low self-worth with certain behaviors with certain people and having wanting multiple somebodies. It's something different, all right? And it really don't even fix you. Just think about it. Think about, does it fix you and make you really feel better, or is it so temporary? Is it a temporary fix? Well, it's like, probably like some of that crack that's going on today. You know, it ain't, people say it ain't nothing like it used to be. Straight bunk. And you're straight bunking yourself because you're giving you a temporary fix. So anyway, moving right on. Number three. Do you believe if a person of the opposite sex looks and speaks to your partner in your presence, and your partner speaks back, that you're being disrespected? That they're disrespecting you. Do you believe that your partner is disrespecting you if she says hi to somebody that says hi to her? They, you know what I'm saying? Or if he says hi to somebody that says hi to him, do you feel that you're being disrespected? Think about that. All right. Number four. Are you in a relationship or in a control ship? A relationship? What do you mean, Mr. Counselor? What do you mean? I'm in a... No. If you go controlling how this goes, how that goes, take your shoes off, do this, do that, do that, and you steady giving drill sergeant orders, you may be not relating, you might be controlling. And so it's something to really, really open your mind and think about. Alright? Number five. Do you believe if you are in a relationship that's not getting any better, that you can learn to get better in your situation? Yes, you can. You can work on you. You can draw a circle around you and work on everything inside that circle. Alright? Number six. Do you believe if your partner or spouse cheats on you, that you have the right to beat on them for what you feel they did to you? Do you believe if your partner cheats that you have a right to put your hands and beat them down? Do you have a right? Huh? No, you don't. No, you don't. No, you don't. You don't own anybody. I don't care if it's your wife, husband, or whatever. Now, it's a piece of paper, but we really, really don't have ownership. A person can walk away anytime they choose to, if they choose to. It's something to think about. You know, you get in a lot of trouble trying to make a person your pet. You know, ownership. You know, you even got to be careful with your real pets today, your dogs and your cats. You know, you can go to jail for harassing them too bad. So, be careful. Number seven. Do you think it's wrong for you or your partner to call the police if you or someone else is causing or trying to cause harm to them? Do you believe that it's wrong for your partner or your ex-partner or whoever, if you're trying to hurt them, do you think it's wrong for them to call the police? I mean, do you really think they should just sit there, just beat the hell out of me, just beat me down, kick my teeth out, all that? Look, I know you got to get your anger out. Go on and get it out. I ain't going to call the police. Do you think that's the attitude you have? And if you do think that, do you feel the same way for your sister? Do you feel the same way for your brother? Do you feel the same way for your mother? I mean, like, is it really cool to beat your family members down and to beat this woman down and don't call the police? Sometimes you're going to have to call somebody. You know, and so I think it's real foolish, you know, and I think that that person that thinks like that needs some real, real help. It might need some help that the counselor is not equipped to give. So, I might have some referrals. So, just check me out. Number 8. Since you have been in this domestic violence program, have you learned that it's better to think smarter instead of harder? It's better to think smarter instead of harder. What does that mean, counselor? I said, better to think smarter instead of harder is like, if most of us had thought smarter, we wouldn't be in a domestic violence class, program, or whatever. You know, it's fine to be a viewer. But we wouldn't be here if most of us thought smarter. But when we think harder, what happens is we end up in San Quentin, Santa Rita, Pelican Bay, all these prisons are here with me in a domestic violence class program or what have you. So, I hope that today's lesson was great for you. I hope you got something. I know you got something. All you have to do is tune in and just open yourself up, you know, and I know you can hear me. You know, this is a God thing, God sent connection thing for me to you. And I look forward to talking to you again. Yours truly, the counselor, Mr. Orton.